Hi, I'm Henry Segerman, and this is Slide Glide Cyclides. So it looks like a sphere made out of 8 bananas. Each banana is attached to the base with an axle that it can rotate around, like this. And there are also bevel gears at the end of the banana that mesh with a crown gear that goes all around the base. And it's connected to this part of the base down here. So if I twist the base down here, the crown gear is going to mesh with the bevel gears on the bananas, and each banana will rotate down. Okay, well, let's see it. So the sphere opens out into a disc in a very satisfying way. This design was discovered by Andrew Kappert in the process of working on a video with Burkhard Polster, also known as Mathologer. Their video is about ways to see why the area of a sphere is 4 pi r squared, 4 times the area of a disk of the same radius as the sphere. And you can see something of the idea in this mechanism. So if the radius of the sphere is r, say, so this distance here, then when you open it out into a disk, here's the radius of the sphere, so the diameter of the sphere is here, that's the radius of the disk. So the area of the disk is 2 times r squared times pi, which works out to 4 pi r squared, which is the formula for the area of the sphere. And you can immediately see that the same amount of stuff makes up the sphere as makes up the disk, because it's all just the same bananas. As the number of bananas goes up, they get thinner, and the shapes at either end of the movement get closer to being the actual sphere and the actual disk. As usual with this kind of visual proof, though, there are some details to worry about to show that things actually converge. For more on comparing areas of spheres and disks with constructions like this, check out Mathologer's video, link in the description.
Folding morphs the surface area of the sphere into the circle of twice the radius. All clear?
So anyway, Andrew came up with the design, then nerd sniped me into making this physical geared version. But why does it work? How come the bananas slide against each other the whole way through their motion, staying in contact? The technical name for the banana shape is a cyclide. One way to define cyclides is that they are the surfaces that you can make as an envelope swept out by spheres in 2 different ways, both from the inside and the outside. This particular cyclide can be thought of as a kind of reflection of a simpler shape, a cone. If you reflect it in an ordinary planar mirror, then you get back the same cyclide. But if you instead reflect in the correct shape, or rather invert in the correct sphere, you get a cone. 8 cones like this can slide together in a kind of irising motion. If we move the cones up and down around the sphere as they iris, then the inverted cyclides give us back the original motion. Inversion in the sphere turns the sliding motion on the cones into rotation of the cyclides, and it turns the lines of contact on the cones into arcs of contact between the cyclides. If you want to print out one of these yourself, I've uploaded the files, link in the description. And to finish up, here are some questions that came up as we were thinking about this. First, is there a way to get the surfaces of the cyclides themselves to do the gearing? I added the standard bevel gears and the crown gear to get the cyclides to move in the right way. But even without the gears, they push each other around because of the arcs of contact. Here I've removed the crown gear so you can see how well they move without the gearing. And the answer is, well, here we go. Once it's near the sphere position, it's not bad. I can just move one of them and it moves all of them. But when it gets down towards the disc, they sort of don't really have much to do with each other. So yeah, here the gearing is really necessary. So can we design the surfaces to ripple in some way so that they grip onto each other and better enforce the motion? Following on from that, I'm interested in mechanisms where pairs of parts are in contact throughout the movement, but they aren't just rotating or translating, or doing a screw motion relative to each other. Gears are the classic example of this, but these cyclides seem to be a completely new example. What other ways are there of making mechanisms with continuous contact between parts that aren't just rotation, translation, or screw motion? All right, this is Slide Glide Cyclides. Thanks for watching.